leader. Nothing you can sing that can't be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. There's nothing you can make that can't be made. No one you can save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be you in time. It's easy. Nothing you can see that isn't shown. No way you can be that isn't where you're meant to be. It's easy. All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need.
Nine a.m. Tuesday, the 1st of December, 1992, at Ari Bell Studios, West London.
ChildLine, say it again. ChildLine, let's go. ChildLine, say it again. ChildLine, let's go.
Bright colours, great. When you go in, as Lisa said, be really quiet. We're going to move you to one side of the set where you must take your shoes off. We use a white floor and it gets really dirty really quickly. So we mustn't have any of your shoes on the white floor. So as soon as you come in, take your shoes off, be told where to put them, and then do exactly what Bill, who is the first assistant director, tells you.
See, bending over and...
Yeah, that's better.
Everything you see, everyone you see has given their services. Tom gave his services, Dave Stewart gave his services. The camera is a present, the lights which were on a minute ago are a present, the studio is a present, all for ChildLine. Every single person here that's doing a job, painting the floor, putting up a marquee so the kids stay warm, absolutely everything. The hamburgers for lunch, all a gift, and just for ChildLine.
That's it, yep. Let's try that. Okay, stand by. Heads down. 1, 2, 3!
It's definitely Cary Grant and Doris Day here.
Photographer Terry O'Neill had agreed to take the record sleeve pictures.
Yeah, great.
Why did you say yes to it as an idea?
Well, I think that it's a great cause, of course. You know, I mean, it's something that that I wanted to do, and the song. You know, when you suggested the song, then I thought it was perfect. Lyrically, it's perfect. It was just trying to. The only concern that I had was to get it away from the way the Beatles did it. You see, because excuse me, when the Beatles did the songs, wrote them and recorded them, they put their stamp on them so much that sometimes it's difficult to try and put it into another pocket, as we say, another beat. Yeah. And you know, that's what Dave did. Dave Stewart did that. So I just sang the song, and he put it into the right groove.
So what did you think when we put this idea to you?
I thought you were completely insane at first, because one, choosing a song like All You Need Is Love, which is, it's like tackling, you know, the 1812th Overture or something. It's like a sacred song recorded by the Beatles in a specific way, and I understand everything about how it was recorded. So my first thought was, oh God, to try and recreate that. And then when you said Tom Jones, which is like, you know, shooting off in another direction, I was trying to sort of imagine the marriage of the two things together. And then I thought, it's a great challenge and I shouldn't really try to recreate anything like that, and just make it something in the 90s, almost the opposite, and made it very sort of Kraftwerk or Erasure-ish or whatever. And then the whole recording process of it was a really funny experience, because it was done in three different places in the world.
Go on.
Well, you know, started off making a backing track with my friend in France. Then we came to London with it, and we met with Tom. And then I recorded Tom in Los Angeles in my friend's garage. And that day, Kiki Dee happened to ring up and just call around, so she ended up singing some backing vocals with Tom. And then I was meant to come back to London to mix it, but in the meantime I got acute appendicitis in Bangkok and had to have an operation there. And then ended up back in London with the tape and adding on more things and mixing it, and eventually here we are trying to make a video.
Running two cameras, 4-1 take back.
Run playback.
I realise it's such an important thing for people to have somebody somewhere to be able to help them or talk them out of anything from suicide to running away to the streets of London to become a hooker or whatever, because of something that they down at talk that's a kind of taboo subject, i.e. sexual abuse at home or whatever. And it's just become more and more apparent. And then when I heard that out of 10,000 phone calls, only 2,500 can be answered, that seems sort of absolutely ludicrous. And 7,500 people with this, not just a normal problem, I mean a problem that's going to affect their whole life, with nobody to talk to, simply because of the lack of finance to man the telephone staff, made it like a mission, really.
Meanwhile, in another studio, celebrities from stage, screen and radio were arriving to record their contributions for the video.
All you need is love.
Very sad to hear that things aren't going financially as well as they should, and I hope that this will all our efforts
round a bit,
bring a few bob in.
Pop star, video star ever known.
We're training her for the future. She's going to take over from me, you see, on Radio 2 eventually. That's and she'll keep me in the manner to which I hope to become accustomed.
Won't she need a beard and all that?
We're working on that. She's certainly got my hairline already.
She's the one. How old is she?
7 weeks.
Ah. But, Dave, did you hear this?
Again.
It's your chance now to discover another star. What about Kate? You think she might...
There's definitely more sort of... You can feel the talent oozing more.
She's got a buzz about her.
Mm. From Kate?
Yes. It's the nappy it's coming from.
It's the mittens, I think.
She's got more dress sense than her father, anyway.
So tell us why you're here.
Well, I think ChildLine is just a vital part, a recent part, but a vital part of what is now our heritage. I think it's the most important thing to happen in recent years as far as children are concerned. I think it's proved by the number of children who have made use of it. If ever there was a need for a service, ChildLine has proved that need.
I'm not going to sing it.
You can't sing?
I'm not going to sing it.
It's so embarrassing. It's, I know, I go through this every day of my life, Diane. I know. Stage fright, bless her. We've got Christian in the car.
That's why she can't sing.
Today is absolute chaos. Every room you go into, there's something going on with a balloon, or there's the whole of the Dankworth family blowing bubbles there, and someone's hammering the bubbles out of the thing. There's your husband wandering around asking small children like mine to blow up more balloons with him. She's going, is this all right, Mum? And I'm saying, yes, I think he's safe, you know, should be all right. There's absolute chaos. There's That's Life presenters in very loud, vibrant jackets, being very jolly. It's good, I'm rather enjoying it.
It is wonderful, isn't it? And Mr. Jones in the middle of it all, like the Pied Piper.
Yes, exactly, yes, just sort of rather bemused and rather tanned.
Rather sexy.
Completely sexy, really. And he just did this song called Kiss, remember that Prince song, which is completely pelvic in all directions, and it was marvellous. And ever since then, we've sort of taken him to our hearts. And he has a funny following between sort of teenagers right up to the great-great-great-grandmothers, and even people like myself think he's a bit groovy.
He is, isn't he?
He is, yes. I think he's dead funky, actually.
There's nothing you can do that can't be done. Nothing you can sing that can't be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy.
I once read something that ChildLine did about children at boarding school. And I went to boarding school, and we had one girl at our school who became extremely homesick. And kept sort of telling the teachers, telling the matron, they all said, oh, don't worry, you'll get over it, everyone always does, which they do, but it's a very toughening process. She thought that if she stopped eating, she would be sent to hospital, and then her mother and father would come and get her and take her home. Well, she stopped eating, and she died of anorexia. And I just think that if something like ChildLine had existed then, maybe she could have phoned them, they would have taken her seriously, alerted her parents and the school properly, and her life could have been saved. And so it was that, really, the fact that ChildLine does pay attention to children in boarding schools, because they're seen as privileged children, and it's not that much of a privilege, actually. I'd never send my child to a boarding school, I'd always keep her at home, because that's why I had her to be with.
All you need is love.
Thank you.
When I was a child, I had good parents who were very understanding, but I was certainly bullied when I was a little chap at primary school, when I was about six, and got through that, and then I was bullied again when I was about 14 or 15 at grammar school. And I don't know if it had any lasting effect, but it certainly makes your life fairly unpleasant. And if something like this, if Childline had been around then, I guess I might have used it. And children these days are obviously very telephone literate, and if they can get on that phone and talk about their problems, we all know talking about problems helps solve them. Starts to solve them anyway.
That's it, and one more time, who's going? Oh, it's not! Yeah! Hang on, keep going, all right, go, keep going, get on! That's it, that's one, yeah.
Bit different from Grange Hill, Danny.
Yeah, it certainly is, yeah.
Have you done lots hectic. Of pop videos?
I've done a few, yeah, I did a few when I was younger, Yeah.
And is it always as hectic as this?
Well, not always. I met some nice people here as well. All the old stars that, you know, when I was a kid. They're all here now, so it's pretty nice. Nice to see them.
Yeah. What can you see?
Andy.
What? Oh, see. Yes, isn't that funny?
Just the choruses, or
yes.
Doing this?
Well, I remember when Childline was launched and the relief in myself that there was actually something for children somewhere where they could phone whether they were having trouble at home or if they just needed to speak to somebody confidentially. And that was such a relief and I was so delighted about it. And the thought of Childline sort of not existing or not being there is sort of unbelievable to me now that we've had it. So I had no qualms about it at all coming along today because I have a small sister and brother and the thought of them ever being in trouble would horrify me.
And I know the many, many cases of children who've rung into Childline desperate, feeling utterly bereft and hopeless, who've ended up finding a solution to their problem, help with their troubles, and a feeling of comfort and safety.
People who buy this record may be kids who are quite unhappy. Mm. So what message do you want them to take from the record?
Well, the ones that are lucky enough, of course, to have good families around them. I mean, that's the thing. I was brought up very well in South Wales. I had a lot of family around me. And when children don't have that, I feel very sorry for them. Because I think that your childhood, it takes you through life. It gives you that base. And with children that are not lucky enough to have that start, then it's a shame, and we should all try to do something for these children. So this record, I think, is a perfect thing because the lyric is so good. You see, all we need is love. I mean, that's all these kids need, is a lot of love and attention. And hopefully, this record will sort of open people's ears and eyes to the fact that these kids definitely need help.
Right, positions please. Come on. Very good. Take your position. Okay. Tom, Do you feel a take coming on?
Yes.
Yes? Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Okay. Good luck, Tom.
Last smile.
Children who daren't ask for help any other way, who daren't go to the police, who daren't go to the social services, do feel that they can pick up a phone and ring 0800 11 11 and speak to someone who cares about them and tell them what's going wrong in their lives, tell them about their pain and get comfort and get protection. And nobody else can reach these children. Sometimes we only hear about these children when it's too late, when the damage has been done, and sometimes it's a really tragic story. So we can catch children when they first turn for help to somebody, and ChildLine is very frequently the only person that they will turn to.
This record, this video, is all about love. So what can people most give you?
What the people in the studio are giving us. Show us you love children and show us you care about them.
Nowhere you can be, that isn't where you're meant to be. It's easy.